Title: The Special People. Chapter 528-529. When Black Rose finished speaking these words, she went outside, and the boss turned to look at Hannah behind the scene. It was a bit interesting. No bottom line? There is no bottom line for women. What did you do? The boss behind the scene is curious. The Black Rose went out. Hannah breathed a sigh of relief. She was proud of you, and wanted to kill me? Hannah's beautiful eyes are all venomous, and they turned over with the Black Rose so quickly, it is really not very good. Fortunately, she learned something. Otherwise, you will lose money. Hannah decided that she would absolutely not be able to go out for the time being. She must wait for her killer ability to reach first class. Hannah is a person without a bottom line, but also a person who works hard to train. She knows that no one can believe now, the only thing she can believe in is herself. So she must improve her strength. Only in this way can I survive and be the first killer. I have to make a lot of money. Sister, Hannah called the boss behind the scenes. Little girl, Black Rose actually said that you have no bottom line. Where have you reached the bottom line? The boss waved her hand behind the scenes and everyone went out. I did something bad. I want to learn the fighting of Black Rose. Hannah lied and opened her mouth. The goal is clear enough. Regardless of the means, it's okay. The boss behind the scene looked at Hannah again. Of course, she was the best. She does things by any means, otherwise how could she be the boss of the killer organization? Thank you, sister, Hannah relieved. Okay, I'll take you to play. The boss stood up behind the scenes. Thank you. Hannah was pleasantly surprised. How quickly did she draw new backers? Was it appreciated in a cluster? She thinks so, but she doesn't know that the boss behind the scenes also has a bottom line. For example, what Hannah does, she may be able to do it for men, but she can't do it for women. Because they are all women. Go, the boss behind the scene wants to see, this Hannah has no bottom line. Huh, Hannah followed with joy. But instead of leaving the bar, she went to other private rooms with large beds and hot springs. How many do you want? The boss asked behind the scenes. Sister, how many? Hannah was stunned. What does that mean? Hannah felt trembling as he thought of something. A person with no bottom line, pay attention to this. I ask, how many do you want? No, I don't want it. Hannah was scared. She was still intact. How could she do anything in such a place? All she needs now is exercise. All she needs is to strengthen herself. She wants to keep herself. Hannah is ruthless, and will not waste time on this. If the boss behind the scenes wants her to come out to play, she will immediately exercise and learn to fight. Perseverance in this regard, Hannah is too high, otherwise she will not grow so fast. No? Little girl, are you 18? The boss looked at her again. No, have you never taught your boyfriend? Yes, but men are used to play and kick. I gave them, didn't they let them play? Hannah always thought so. This is a good idea, but I don't like seeing women or it's still the same, so how many do you want? The boss behind the scene sat down and took a glass of red wine. I don't want it, I really don't want it. Hannah was anxious. She thought so, but she still wanted to get married later. No. You have no bottom line, how can you do something with a bottom line? You don't say it, then I will help you. Reject, you can go out. And if you don't refuse, lie down to me. The boss behind the scene said. Hannah bit her lips, she was tangled, and she must be dead when she went out, but her body is for her husband. Hannah's eyes were red. She didn't move and didn't dare to go out. Black Rose would kill herself when she went out. She lay down. There was no way. She had hatred in her heart. The boss smiled slightly behind the scenes and pressed a button in a place. Call a few. No, I like Own City. Hannah burst into tears. Own City? Our American men are more handsome than your city men and have better facial features, the boss said. I want my own city. I'm from Huaxia City. I like my city man. Hannah looks down on city men, but if she gets married, she will still choose Huixia. Just you, call someone in. Huixia, Hannah wiped away her tears, she was poisonous, you actually force me so well, I must revenge you Hannah. You wait for me. Hannah was surrounded by humiliation. She already had a plan. Today's shame, she wants to let the behind-the-scenes boss pay back 100 times. Behind the scene, the boss was drinking red wine, and there was a hint of teasing in her blue eyes. She took out her mobile phone and called someone. Follow the Black Rose, I want to know where she is. She can't die so fast, don't let her discover. The Black Rose came out and she got in the car. What can she do? She was expressionless and wiped away her tears with a tissue, which was sad. She swears that she will never be nice to anyone afterwards. For the first time, she got this result. Black Rose drove, she knew where Chuck said, she stomped on the throttle, let's be done. She must get back her photos, even if she die. Mom, the photos have been sent to her, Chuck said to Karen Lee. Well, is she angry? Karen Lee was helpless. She hadn't done such a thing before. She did things neatly. This is really true. Well, especially angry, Chuck thought of the tone of Black Rose's words, and Chuck wanted to laugh. Don't do this in the future, do you know? Karen Lee said solemnly. Yes, my mother, I promise you that. Of course, Karen Lee was relieved of Chuck. Betty asked. Do you want someone to come out? No, I understand the person of Black Rose, she will come over, this kind of photo is the most important to her, she can't let others see. Well, it's important for all women, Betty said. Chuck shrugged awkwardly, Mom, Sister Betty, I haven't done that kind of thing. It's not about you, Karen Lee smiled slightly, I can't control you too much, but remember to respect the woman, your dad respects me particularly, and I respect him too. It is best to respect each other as a guest. Well, Chuck envied. He looked at Yvette. Yvette came back and kept her head down and bit her lips. Chuck hoped that one day he would be able to hold a wedding with Yvette. But can this day come? You won't have to do it later, I will come with the Black Rose, Karen Lee said. After a person is angry, desperate and sad, what can be done, it is inestimable, dogs can jump over the wall in anxiety, not to mention Black Rose. In this case, Karen Lee personally handled it best. As long as the Black Rose came out, she couldn't run away. Okay, my mother, I listen to you, Chuck just looked at it. Yvette bowed her head and had no comments. However, I heard from you just now that I think Black Rose is a bit. Karen Lee didn't know how to describe it. This kind of photo was taken by a trusted person, and it was concealed. It would be a personal collapse. Karen Lee suddenly felt that this Black Rose was a bit pitiful. She killed herself for money, and Karen Lee resisted both times without any loss. This was her own responsibility. The conflict is not too big, the only thing is to beat his son last time. This is absolutely not tolerable to Karen Lee. What's something? Mom? Chuck asked. It's nothing, Karen Lee shook her head and asked Betty to look outside. Maybe Black Rose would engage in a sneak attack. Betty went out. Karen Lee looked at Yvette, do you want to start? Yvette looked down, she wanted to see how Karen Lee shot. Wanted to learn. Chuck didn't know whether to speak or not, and could only keep silent. After a while, Chuck looked at the time, he frowned. Did Black Rose not want this photo? Still want to let yourself send out her photos? Chuck called Black Rose and connected. No, you want me to take your picture. I'm coming. This is the voice of Black Rose. Chuck heard the roar of the rumbling engine. A sports car gallops from a distance. And it's the Black Rose that drives. Black Rose drove over, she was reporting the determination to die, she was dead, and the photos would be destroyed. Karen Lee, Chuck, Yvette, and Betty all looked at the Black Rose driving by. This villa, it was a super large, empty courtyard, and the Black Rose car stopped. The Black Rose came down, and there was blood in the big blue eyes. I'm here, give me the picture. The sound is dry. Black Rose does things with the utmost attention to cleanliness. She didn't expect to be caught by the handle this time. And it's still that kind of picture. Black Rose attaches the most importance to her body, not the injured one, but the psychological one. It's been a long time since Black Rose debuted, and she has never made any men. At that time, the boss was looking at her and wanted to find some people who broke her. Black Rose refused directly. It can be said that the Black Rose is particularly conservative in this respect, but the photo was taken and still seen. She came over, her eyes were all red. Hannah, she already hated her. Chuck looked at her calmly, as did Yvette. The Black Rose came quite simply. But why didn't Hannah come? Chuck frowned. Chuck, give me the photo. Black Rose walked in front of four people. Karen Lee looked at her like this. Return the photo to me. The Black Rose growled. Karen Lee, I know you want to kill me, okay, you let your son give me the picture first. Black Rose's bloody eyes stared at Karen Lee. Karen Lee kept looking at her. Black Rose took out her gun and faced to herself. Karen Lee was expressionless and Chuck touched his nose. There was a little surprise. Black Rose valued the photo so much. How many shots? Black Rose said hoarsely. She had thought of a sneak attack, but she knew that her own strength was not Karen Lee's opponent, so what use was the sneak attack? Two lessons from the past, she assassinated Karen Lee twice, both after the strictest arrangement, but the final result was still a failure. Karen Lee was not hurt twice, and the gap was obvious. What's more, Karen Lee is specifically waiting for her, her own photos are still in the hands of others, and she has no chance. So she chose the most direct method. Get back my photos. Karen Lee. I will ask you how many shots will your son give me the picture? I ask you. Black Rose growled. She was really hurt by Hannah. She won't treat anyone anymore. I don't need you to shoot yourself. Karen Lee shook her head. Black Rose can come over, so Karen Lee has enough strength to deal with her. There is no need to let Black Rose shoot herself. This is not consistent with her usual style. Karen Lee likes fair play. If you want to kill, then you can just come over and fight with me. Karen Lee is like that. Her strength is enough to support her like this. But yes. Peng. Black Rose pulled the trigger, a bullet pierced her body, blood flowed out, and Black Rose didn't frown. She was pale and sweaty. Karen Lee was surprised, Chuck, Yvette, Betty was stunned. Give me the picture. The Black Rose growled. You don't have to do this. Karen Lee shook her head. Peng. The Black Rose pulled the trigger again, and the bullet pierced her body again. Blood is coming. With two shots, half of Black Rose's body was stained with blood. Black Rose was shot twice, she stood still, and the sweat on her forehead fell to the ground. Return the photo to me. Black Rose's big eyes were blood red, and her voice was hoarse to the extreme. Karen Lee watched her silent for a few seconds. Chuck, give her the picture. Well, Chuck took out the cell phone he picked up to Hannah. Karen Lee catches the Black Rose. Black Rose reached out to pick up, Karen Lee shook her head, gun. My son is here, I don't want anyone to use a gun. The gun is too dangerous. In case of a shot, no one can carry it. Snapped. Black Rose threw the gun on the ground. She took the phone tremblingly and opened it. There were a lot of photos and even a videos. After she deleted all of them, she was completely at ease and took back her photos. She wanted to cry. Never encountered such a thing. You assassinated me twice, I cannot care about you. But you hurt my son, hurt Logan. These two things, I will count with you. Karen Lee looked cold. This is something she can't tolerate. The Black Rose broke the phone, her eyes were red with blood, covered with bloodshot eyes, and her hands were covered with two gunshot wounds. The blood was still straight. Okay, I know I can't escape today, you can kill me now. It's easy to kill you. Even before you shoot yourself, it's still easy to kill you. Karen Lee was cold. Her strength, killing Black Rose is simple. This is regardless of injury or no injury, For Karen Lee's strength, there is no difference. Yes, it's easier for you to kill me. Now it's even simpler. Black Rose didn't have any fear. I will not bully you. Three moves, you can resist my three moves, you can go. Karen Lee said. You the Black Rose froze, three strokes? She did not expect Karen Lee to say such a thing. But she heard it and was not so surprised. She wanted to kill Karen Lee very much. She had followed Karen Lee for a long time. She thought that Karen Lee, who was so powerful, would be a cruel, unscrupulous person, but it's not. Black Rose herself has to admit that Karen Lee is a very special person. If someone respects her, she will pay back. Karen Lee should be ruthless to others and good to others, especially with principles. That's why Karen Lee said this. Three strokes, if you promised not to deal with my son anymore, then three strokes. It can be used to make up for the injuries you shot yourself. Karen Lee said. Black Rose looked at Chuck, she bit her lips. I can't kill him now. I told you to say it later, yep. That's ready, three strokes. Karen Lee walked out. Black Rose covered her wound and stared at her. Suddenly, Karen Lee punched out. The strength of her arm is amazing. But this punch hit her, and the Black Rose flew out and fell to the ground like a movie, spitting blood. Black Rose climbed up, two gunshot wounds had hit her. She had no energy to resist this punch. Black Rose fainted. Karen Lee walked over, and Black Rose gritted her teeth hard. Karen Lee punched out again. Black Rose snorted and fell 5 or 6 meters. She spit blood and wriggled on the ground, dying. With these two punches, Karen Lee didn't keep her hands. Black Rose finally knew the gap between the two, and even if she didn't get hurt, she couldn't resist the two punches. Get up. Karen Lee said coldly. The Black Rose gritted her teeth, but there was no more energy. The blood on her body bled more, and her limbs were weak. Get up. Karen Lee repeated. The Black Rose lips were bitten, and she barely shivered and climbed up. Boom. Fist banged. Woo. The Black Rose fell out, into the grass in the yard, motionless, and blood had spread. Karen Lee turned around. Chuck, let's go in. Chuck shrugged and pulled Yvette into the house, and Betty also entered the house. Karen Lee arranged for Chuck and Yvette to return to the room. Karen Lee said, only the Black Rose came, and that Hannah did not come. This, will the Black Rose kill her? Betty analyzed. Is this something a normal person would do? The person who secretly took the photo, Black Rose knows the truth, and will definitely kill Hannah. In other words, she will do the same. This is possible, but this girl, Hannah, has such a big idea and will be killed as simple as that. Karen Lee was thinking about this. To be honest, she felt ashamed of Hannah's behavior. So, what do you mean? Betty's eyes flickered. This Hannah pays close attention to find her as much as possible. If you die, you can't find the body, then this Hannah is definitely not dead. Karen Lee's sixth sense is very strong. She always feels that someone is somewhere mocking, and this man is Hannah hiding in the dark. Yes, I will check now. Betty said. Karen Lee nodded. She looked outside, and the place remained motionless.